Welcome to this brief guide on how to share your out of office with your team using Outlook. So you've been lucky enough to secure that 1 week vacation, or perhaps you just need to take some personal leave and you want to let your team know that you'll be out of office. But you don't want to inadvertently block out their calendars as well by accident. So today I'm going to show you how to correctly share your out of office using Outlook. The first thing we'll need to do is to select the drop-down menu next to new email and create a new meeting. You can also use the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+Shift+Q to achieve this. In the body of your meeting request, if you see a Teams meeting invite added automatically, you'll need to remove this by selecting the button that will appear next to the Teams meeting that says Don't Host Online. Once you've removed the Teams meeting invite, the next thing we'll need to do is to select the dates that we'll be on leave. In my demonstration, I'm going to be on leave from the 21st all the way through until, say, the 25th. I'm going to take the whole week off. The next thing I need to do is I make sure that I tick the box that says all day. This helps minimize the impact to other people's calendars, whilst also making it easier for them to see who is out of office. The next thing we'll need to do is to select the response options button and untick the option that says request responses. This will mean that people will not need to accept or decline your meeting request. You'll notice it will also remove the option to allow new time proposals when you remove request responses. The next thing we need to do is to set the availability. Now, the first thing that most people think is, oh, I'm going to be out of office, but your teammates will not be. So in this instance, you need to make sure that you select free. This will ensure that it won't block out their calendars as well. And then make sure that you set the reminder to none. We don't need them getting a reminder at midnight on the day that you're going on annual leave. Now, once we've got all those options set, we can put in the title for our out of office meeting request. In this case, the best option is to put your name and then the reason as to why you're on leave. This makes it easier for potentially your manager to see who is on leave and why, especially if they have multiple reports who may be on leave at the same time. Once you've put in the title, all you then need to do is basically select the required option and add in your teammates. In this case, I'm going to put in my alternate identity, also known as Paul O'Malley. And once I've got all that sorted, the only thing I need to do then is hit that lovely little send button, and my out of office has been sent to my team. And that is how you correctly share your out of office availability with your team using Outlook. I hope you found this tip extremely useful, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.